Very good morning to all of you children. I hope you are enjoying good health at home. And today I will re-explain the chapter 7 of your Honeydew book, that is A Visit to Cambridge, written by Firdaus Kanka. See class, as I have told you earlier that this chapter is about two physically disabled persons. One of them is Firdaus Kanka, who is a famous writer or journalist, and the other one is Stephen Hawking, who is famous or great astrophysicist who has done a lot of work in astrology, who has done a lot of works in space inventions and discoveries. Now let's get started with the chapter. These two people, Firdaus Kanka is having the problem of brittle bones, where the bones of a human being or individual breaks easily. And Stephen Hawking had the problem of paralysis, where he could not move his movie. He could not move his body, and he could only move his fingers and expresses his views, or he interact with other people through a computer generated voice by punching the keys of his keyboard on the wheelchair. Firdaus Kanka too moves in, or he is too able to walk, he is not able to walk or go anywhere. They both are on wheelchairs. Firdaus Kanka is a famous, he is a journalist or a writer who is settled in Mumbai. Now Firdaus Kanka is visiting, or he has visited, he was visiting Britain, and he was writing a book or something on my travels in Britain. And he was visiting Cambridge on this purpose only. He was visiting Cambridge to write about his book, My Travels to Britain. And he was walking with the guide in Cambridge University. And then he expressed that while he is in Cambridge, it was like he is traveling the whole Britain. Because Cambridge University was one of the famous universities of the world, was situated in Britain. And it was just then the guide was with him in the walking tour of that Cambridge University. He told about Stephen Hawking, and he called him poor but a worthy successor of Isaac Newton, because he was a scientist and he was equally very brainy, a very great achiever, who was very worthy successor of Isaac Newton, who was also a professor at that Cambridge University, and he had his chair in a Cambridge University. Just then the author realized, Firdaus Kanka realized, he has missed meeting Stephen Hawking, and then he felt that he should meet the great scientist Stephen Hawking, who was a well-known public figure and also a writer of bestseller book A Brief History of Times. Now he, after the walking tour was over, he made up his mind that he should meet this man, meet Stephen Hawking, and for that he rushed to a telephone booth and he called at Stephen Hawking's residence, and there he talked to his assistant. He told him about he has come all the way from Mumbai to write about his book, My Travels to Britain, and he wanted to meet Stephen Hawking so that he could mention about his meeting in his book. So he got an appointment of next day for half an hour, that was from 3:30 to 4 o'clock, and the very next afternoon Stephen Hawking and Firdaus Kanka were sitting face to face, where he was interviewing or a kind of conversating with Stephen Hawking. The first thing he asked him was, there are many people who think or who tell physically disabled people to be courageous, to have to be brave. Is it so? Means these kind of people annoy you, they make you irritated, and they make you feel that you are someone who is not like other healthy people. says the only thing which motivates you or which inspires you is looking into the people or looking up people or finding a people finding a person who is physically disabled or who is just like you but who has achieved something great. And so is with Firdaus Kanga. He was physically disabled, but he got inspired when he met Stephen Hawking because he was a public figure. He has achieved a lot of things in his life. Then he asked Stephen Hawking that there are many people who feel that being physically disabled is means the one who is born with physical disability is always unhappy. And to this, Stephen Hawking said, "No, I don't feel like this, and I feel it quite amusing whenever people think like this." He said it was really very amusing or very annoying whenever people think that one who is born with disability is always unhappy. It's not like that. And then he said, being brave was the only choice I had because I had nothing, I could not do anything. So I kept my courage and I was brave enough to cope up with my disability, and that I was mentally prepared that I cannot move for my whole life, but this is what I have to go on with. मुझे अपनी इसी physical disability के साथ जीना होगा. I have to be brave. This was means being brave was the only option Stephen Hawking had when he was a child. Now, Firdaus Kanga then asked him, does he feels annoyed or does he feel bad whenever people like him come and disturb him from his work? And to this, Stephen Hawking said, yes, I do get disturbed. And in a funny way, in a joking way, he said this. After saying it, he smiled a little. Now, in the upcoming things, Firdaus Kanga, in upcoming paras, the next paras, Firdaus Kanga explains about the appearance of Stephen Hawking. And he tells that Stephen Hawking looks like the 3D image or 3D figure of his magazine images. He is just like the 3D image of his magazine pictures, and that time was wearing a blue shirt and a trouser, and he was just like his magazine images. He was exact a copy of his magazine pictures. There was no difference. The only thing which was different was he was a brilliant man who was bounded by the machine or the computer generated voice. Now, he knew that there was a inner glow in the author looked at Stephen Hawking. He felt that it was a kind of lantern who was bounded by the walls of disability or who was confined into a wheelchair, but there was something, the light of him, there was a light inside his body, in terms of knowledge or in terms of his works and great things he had done, inventions or discoveries. He was like a lantern who was bounded by the thin walls of glass, but there was an inner glow in his body. There was something which glowed or which glow off brightly. There was a bright light inside him, and that light was the light of knowledge which he spread through his words or through his works. Now, the author asked him, being disabled, have you found or what do you think, what is the best thing about being disabled? And the author, Stephen Hawking, said, I don't think there is nothing good in being disabled. And then the author said, yes, there is a good thing. That is, you get to know or you get to see a lot of kindness in the world. You see people are very kind to you and all the world seems kind. And then it was, yes, really true. He agreed, yes, it is true that people are kind to the ones who are physically disabled. Now, every time he was talking to Stephen Hawking, he was feeling that he is really more disabled in the terms, he was far better. At least he was he could move his limbs, he could move his hands, but in case of Stephen Hawking, he could not move his hands or any part of the body except fingers. So he was feeling that he was far better in terms of body. And then he asked him, means he had been a motivation for a lot of people, and he had inspired, Stephen Hawking had inspired himself as well, means Firdaus Kanga as well. And to this, the scientist said, no, I don't think I'm an inspiration to all, because I cannot inspire even myself. I am confined to the, means my life is limited to wheelchairs only. So to this, Firdaus Kanga realized that he has asked him a really bad question. And then it was like he, before going to back to home, when the appointment was about to over, he asked him what advice would he like to give to the people. And then he said, Stephen Hawking said, I would like to advise people that they should work on, or they should concentrate on the things in which they are good at, and they should not waste their time in unnecessary things like Paralympics or Olympics for disabled people. And then the author also realized, recollected his memories of past or his childhood memories when he was forced to learn guitar, Spanish guitar, even he was disinterested in learning that. And once he was so pissed off learning that Spanish guitar that he had to unstring, he broke the wires of that guitar so that he could get rid of learning this guitar. And then it was about the half an hour was over, and it was time for him to go. And he was he said, it's half an hour is up, and I think I have annoyed you a lot, I have disturbed and irritated you a lot, but now it's my time to leave. And he thanked him and he bid him goodbye. He was about to go, but Stephen Hawking said, stay, have tea with me, and I will show you the garden. And when they entered the garden, it was a huge place, a sort of garden, and they both went in their wheelchairs. Inch by inch they covered the garden, and about half an hour, 1 hour later, an hour later, it was the time for Firdaus Kanga to go. And when it was about to go, he looked back and he was thankful that he had met the most brilliant man in the earth, Stephen Hawking, and he was thankful. While he was going away from Stephen Hawking, he turned back, and he could feel that Stephen Hawking is waving his hand and saying him goodbye. So class, this was the chapter. I hope you will understand it. And with this, you will have to do some exercises or extra questions. These questions are, I am writing it down on board. You have to do it in your FAIR notebook after the comprehensive passages. Okay? So the first question which you have to do is, who was Firdaus Kanga? Okay? And next question is, how did Stephen Hawking communicate? Second question is, how did Stephen Hawking communicate? Next question, explain the appearance, appearance of Stephen Hawking. which you have to do after hearing, after watching the video or after watching the explanation of the chapter. Question number one, who was Firdaus Kanga? Next, how did Stephen Hawking communicate? Next, explain the appearance of Stephen Hawking. And the last question is, what is the good thing about being a physically disabled person? So class, that's it for today.